Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. Today I am going to just turn the camera on. I was making some flowers and I don't know if anyone has done a tutorial on this, but I kind of started making them up as I went along here. Anyway, so what I've done is I had already started and then I thought maybe I should turn the camera on. Is I've just gotten a piece of cardstock on the back, and then I got a piece of regular burlap material, and I took my glue gun and put glue all along the bottom here. Laid the burlap down and then smashed it in place to hold it on, to hold the burlap onto the card. And then what I want to do is just cut strips, because what I'm using the burlap for is a flower. So I figure I could get like three leaves out of this, and I'm just doing a rough draft of cutting leaves, and I'm going from corner to corner, and I'm just rounding the sides, and it just turns into a really cool leaf. And see, there's paper there, but I'm not worried about that. I'm just gonna just make a bunch of leaves here, and I think this piece of paper is like a 5x7 piece of paper. I don't measure. These were papers that I got from Club Scrap. I'm just using like all my cardstock, and it doesn't really matter what color you have underneath. See, this, I didn't glue it that well, so I didn't. There we go. I guess if you wanted to make them fancy, you could do, you know, put green under there or blue. I'm sure the color will come through. So, like, if you want to do these for Halloween or something, you can always use different color cardstock, and I think some of the color will come through. Also, see, I didn't put that much glue, so it didn't stick that well. Also, I think you can spray them. Let me see here. Let me grab my spray. This is Lime Twist. And I think if you spray them, yeah, see, they'll take the color because there's paper under there. So that's a cool little technique. I'm gonna do a couple. Oh, there you go, see, and then you just let them dry. So you get quite a few leaves out of, you know, this 5x7. Cut the strips and then cut in thirds or whatever size you want your leaf to be, and then just cut the corners off. And I always say it doesn't have to be perfectly shaped. You can shape your leaf any shape you want. Nature isn't perfect, so need to worry about that. Finally had a chance to come into my scrap room today, and I don't really feel like doing anything. I'm working on my junk journal, which is over here. That way I can show you a finished junk journal before I release my kit. And I'm just not in the mood. So I thought if maybe if I make some flowers or something, I will get in back into the scrappy mojo. Okay, so I'm just going to clean this mess here. Those are my leaves. The other thing I was doing last night was making some book paper rolled roses. And I will show you for those new subbies that don't know how to do them, probably, maybe. So I have this really old cookbook that I've been tearing apart. And you can make two of these flowers out of one sheet of book page. And I'm going to make a cut a circle, but I'm doing like a wavy circle. And then I'm going to cut a spiral inside the circle, but it's also going to be a wavy spiral. Now, the thinner you make it here, the skinnier right here, the lower that your flower will stand at the height. If you make it taller or thicker, your flower will stand up taller. So what I mean is, see how tall that stands up? If you cut this really skinny right here, then that's how tall your flower will be once you wrap it up. So now I'm gonna grab this. And I always use a tweezers. For me, it's really easy. So I always make my spiral. I'm right-handed, so I go from right to left, and that's how I cut my spiral. That way, since I'm right-handed, I can grab, with the tweezers, I can grab this little piece here on the end, and then just start twisting with my right hand. So that's what you do. Just hold the paper and twist it. And there's lots of tutorials out there. I made this flower like over, I don't know, 5-6 years ago. I've got an older tutorial. Okay, so then I just hold it. And you want to just let it unravel. See? And you can hold the center and just pull it a little bit tighter before you glue it down. I got too much unravel. It's hot, so I have the fan going, and the fan blew it more than I wanted it. Okay, so then I'm just going to hold it, and down here is where you're going to glue it. So I'm just going to take some glue and just fold this over. Kind of lay it down. Okay. Remember, hot glue is hot. It doesn't burn me. I'm used to it. So if you can, always be careful of that. Okay, so there's your little flower. This camera is going to be the death of me. There we go. There's the little flower. Okay, there we go. I'm sorry, it doesn't self-focus. Then I want to take like a flat back pearl or something for the center. Which, yeah, I think I have one here. My desk is a mess right now. Do a flat back purl and just add a little bit of glue and put that purl right in there. And let's see if I can get a good focus. There you go. Pretty? Okay. So, okay. So now I want to get kind of a vintagey feel. So I just have a piece of some of my favorite curtain material. I think I got this at the swap meet, and I love it because it's got this like bumpy texture. It's really pretty. And I'm just going to cut a little strip here so I can use some. Let me get my, oh, here they are, my material scissors. Okay. And I'm just going to cut a little piece. This. So I'm going to grab two leaves and just glue it on here. Let me see, maybe I can. Yeah, I'm just going to fold it over. Just like that. And I'm going to round off these little corners, these little points right here. See the little points? And I'm going to get my flower. I can see that's a little bit too big, so. Glue my flower. And then I'm going to glue my leaf. And see that yucky part? I can put to the bottom and you won't see it. And then glue my other leaf. Like that. Came out really cute. And I don't like this flopping, so I'm going to just put a little bit more glue back here and just kind of scooch it. Gather it and scooch it in there a little bit. Cute. Now if I want, I can go ahead and trim up the leaf to size. And we have this cute little flower. Then we eat corn dogs every once in a while, so I've been saving the corn dog sticks and washing them. And what I did was I just cut them down the center, cut them in half, and made like a little stem, and with the rest of the lace here, just cut another little piece. I can just make like a little stem. Oops, need some more glue. And I'm just going to wrap it. Remember, be very careful. I got glue all over my fingers. Okay. And I think we can just make a little spray here. Really, really cute little vintage spray. And then you can put these on your projects, and I will show you a project that I made using that little flower. It is right here. Let's see if I can there we go. And it's the little spray. There's the lace. I threw some beads and just a little art tile, some pearls, and it looks really, it's just one of those, you know, little peed moss or little paper mache potting things. And all I did was wrap it with some vintage paper, throw some lace around it, paint it, of course, painted it white. And came out really cute. Then I made a whole set. Just a little vintage kind of really shabby, shabby little set. And you can put little goodies inside. This will actually be a gift for someone. So, that's what I've been doing today, trying to get my mojo back, and we will see. We'll see if I succeed in getting the mojo back. Actually, it should go like that. Okay. Thank you, everyone, for stopping by. Thank you for all your beautiful comments, always. Welcome to all my new subbies. And thank you to my old subbies. And may God bless you all. Bye, everyone.